now that I have something I never really expected to get, which is a Master Grade Full Armor Mark II, I kind of wanted to do something else, and I mentioned it briefly in the actual review. And that would be making a Super Full Armor Mark II. Taking the G-Defensor parts and putting them onto the Full Armor Mark II. Because I don't really see why that would be a problem, really. The backpacks are exactly the same. There's no difference, so I can literally just swap the one to the other without having to take off the armor on the Full Armor Mark II. One thing I did forget to mention in the review is there's actually a little grenade launcher built into the armor on the left forearm. I guess because it doesn't use the shield of the normal Mark II right now, because there's nowhere to put it, so they just put it in the arm. Although I have seen interpretations of the Mark II full armor with that shield pegged onto the double barrel beam rifle here. Nobody'd actually do it without like modifying and gluing on, but it is kind of cool to keep both shields. So I'm just gonna smash these two together and see if it works. And here it is, the 1100 Master Grade Super Full Armor Gundam Mark II. And it did require a little bit of fooling around. It's not an exact 100% swap and connect. Because you see, it's a very, very close shave putting the G-Defensor onto the Mark II. There's not much space left over in the back area, we'll just slide the backpack on. And unfortunately, with a little bit of extra bulk on the shoulders, it's just enough. But not with these, the little thrusters that were pegged onto the back of the shoulders, so I had to unpeg them. I mentioned in the review I glued them. Well, if I'm going to glue something onto a third-party kit, I don't usually put a lot of glue just in case something happens like this that I have to take it off. So I just pulled it off. Nothing broke, and there was just enough space to get this out. And I love the fact that the way the arms are designed, it just covers, like, just the little spikes go right into that area to keep them on. Yeah, that thing doesn't peg in the best. But it will peg into the hand, so you just have to get rid of the beam rifle and give it the long-range rifle, or whatever it's called. So you can get that. And of course, the beam rifle, like I said, it's got to be left to the side. Which isn't a huge deal because you have to also omit the shield from the full armor. Because, well, obviously there's nowhere to put it. These big binders, which also, I guess, double as shields, so they kind of make this thing pointless. It has the energy clips for the rifle, but since you can't hold the rifle and the long rifle, and you have this double-barreled beam rifle anyways, it's not a huge deal, really. And you also have those grenades on the arm, if you really need to use them. And, of course, the Vulcans and the beam sabers. So, and, of course, I can't forget, missile spam is always good. So, yeah, this thing is really loaded up. It's obviously going to be slow as hell, because it's, like, the full armor. It does have the extra thrusters, but that full armor must weigh it down. So, having the new G-Defensor would give us some more thrust, obviously, from the G-Defensor itself, but the added bulk is nothing will weigh down with the armor. But now you can have a Super Full Armor Mark II and a normal Mark II. Of course, I have the Full Armor backpack on there, because I just swapped the two backpacks, because why not? And as far as I can tell, I tried. You can't peg this shield into the arm of the normal arm connector where the shield would go, because this is a slightly bigger peg. You have to like file it down. Which I really like this. It's weird. I feel like there should have been a way to peg the triple grenade launcher on here. I think those little holes look like they could kind of fit it, but as far as I can tell, they don't. It's a weird shape, so it doesn't quite go in. But not a huge deal. This thing has enough weapons as it is, so yeah, this is kind of cool. I don't think I'm going to display it like this. I like having the Super Gundam and the full armor side by side. But it's cool to know that you can do it. Just gotta modify it slightly, not breaking or cutting anything, just a little bit of modification. Although I would worry about doing it too much. Those pegs in the back, I noticed they were starting to stress a little bit. Because like I said, you really gotta smush it together because there's no space. So be a little careful. So that's about it. And I'll see you in the next review.